Hello, 3D printing friends. This flex plate from SliceWorx for the Bambu Lab A1 and the X1 and P1 series printers exerts a mighty grip on PLA, ABS, and PETG during printing. And we'll get a quick look at it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hi, welcome back. Okay, so today we're taking a look at this double-sided, textured, PEI-coated flex plate from SliceWorx. And I'd like to thank SliceWorx for sending this over so we could take a look at it. And while the one I'm showing is specifically sized for the larger Bambu Lab printers, SliceWorx also has these for the Bambu Lab A1 Mini and for the Creality K1 and the K1 Max. And that Creality one also fits on certain Ender 3 models, and there are more sizes coming soon. So you might be thinking, it's a flex plate, so what? Everybody makes those. Well, yeah, there are a lot of them out there, and for the most part, they're good. But also, for the most part, they are generalists, accommodating a wide variety of filament types. These SliceWorx plates have one job. They provide excellent adhesion for PLA, PETG, and ABS. I mean, I guess you could say they have three jobs, since they work with those three filament types, but that's their reason for existence. These plates are hyper-focused on doing a good job with those three materials, but there are a lot of materials out there, so that means there are a lot of filament types in the not-compatible list. SliceWorx strongly recommends against using this plate with certain materials, which I will now list. Do not print with ASA, Polymakers PolySmooth PLA or PVB, nylon, polycarbonate, and that includes nylon and polycarbonate filaments that are reinforced with glass fiber or carbon fiber. And then there's the flexible stuff. It's also on the do not list. This includes STTPU, which is a filament I didn't even know about until now. It's sort of like PLA while it's on the spool, but then it starts to get more like TPU after it's been printed as it absorbs moisture from the air. Weird stuff, and I want to look into it. Also, PLA Flex or flexible PLA like this stuff from Ataraxia Art, which is supposed to be like TPU, but it's PLA. And of course, plain old TPU. Don't use that on this flex plate either. Now when SliceWorx says not compatible, I think what they mean is you should only print with these materials if you plan to use the flex plate as part of the finished product because you are not getting the prints off of it. So just to reiterate, it's only for PLA, PETG, and ABS. As for cleaning it, you do that just by wiping with a paper towel and water, or occasionally washing with water and a drop of dish soap to remove finger oils. And that brings me to another do not thing. Do not clean the plate with acetone or alcohol, also known as IPA. That's isopropyl alcohol, not India Pale Ale. But you probably shouldn't use that either. That would be irresponsible. Get it? Be irresponsible? So anyway, acetone or alcohol will ruin the plate, so keep them away. Now, because giving my build plates a quick wipe with IPA in between print jobs is my go-to bed cleaning move, I'm actually pretty proud of myself for not doing that to this flex plate in the time that I've had it. So I've been using this plate off and on for a couple of months now, and it's performed really well for me. As a test to show you the bed adhesion, I made a test print in Bambu Studio. I added a cube to the build plate and resized it, making it 15 by 15 millimeters by 100 millimeters tall. Then I tilted it 45 degrees and pushed it through the build plate so it was making good contact at the bottom. I sliced it and printed it in Bambu Lab Basic PLA in blue, and it stuck like a champ. So I sliced it again and printed it in some red, printed solid Jesse PETG. Bambu Studio wanted to use a brim, but I turned that off. I wanted to see how it would do without it, and it also stuck well. And then I sliced it and printed it in some generic white ABS, and again, it stuck well as expected. Actually, it took a little bit more flexing than I expected to set it free. The only problem with this ABS print is that the slicer didn't seem to run the fans at all, so there's a bit of a defect along this one corner, but this was a test of bed adhesion, not cooling, so that doesn't matter. Looking at all three prints, the corners on the thin side didn't curl up at all. The part of the prints that touched the flex plate stayed flat on the flex plate through the entire print. I didn't even clean the plate between these prints, and it didn't seem to matter going from one material to the next. As flex plates go, this one seems to be higher maintenance than others and limits you to certain filament types. Okay, actually, I take back the higher maintenance part, considering you're just supposed to wipe it with water. As maintenance goes, that's stupid easy. I guess what I meant to say is you have to be mindful of not using your usual flex plate cleaning routine because alcohol or acetone will damage it. But if you're only printing PLA or PETG or ABS, and you're in the market for another flex plate for your Bambu Lab printer, large or small, or your Creality K1 or K1 Max, give this flex plate some consideration. I found it interesting that it held onto the ABS a little more strongly than the PLA or PETG, but that's a good thing because of the three, ABS is the one that's more likely to warp off the bed. So if you're interested in checking it out, go visit SliceWorx.com and search for Dipped, or just click the link in the description. Plus, use the coupon code BV3D5 to get 5% off the build plates. Actually, that code will get you 5% off your entire order. Thanks again to SliceWorx for sending this flex plate over and for that coupon code to save you a few bucks. I don't know if or when that code will expire, so if July 2024 is way back in the rearview mirror when you try to use it and it doesn't work, well, I guess it expired. Thank you for watching, and big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones, and also because it makes me smile when you do. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one, and now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.